1, 2, 3, maybe 5, maybe 10. How many backgrounds have you done recently? Here I have some bunch. Many of you created loads of outstanding, amazing backgrounds. You broke a blank page. You have so many starting pages, but you have no idea where to go next. Don't worry, I'm here to help you today. I'm delighted that I will share with you my knowledge, my feeling about focal point. I will point you out your focal points. I will help you to choose them, to find out what could be your focal point. I will show you examples, and I hope this will be helpful, and I hope you will have a good time with me. So let's start. For better understanding, I decided to divide our focal point subject into 10 different sections, 10 ways, 10 ideas, however we wish to call it. I decided to kind of organize it for you to understand it better. And in this point, I would love to ask you if you could take notes actually for yourself, because I hope this video will include everything that will come up to my mind regards the focal point, how I see it, how I use it, what I do, what sort of ideas I have. So maybe make notes. Unless you wish to create while I chat, feel free to do whatever works for you. And I hope this will be helpful, and I hope it will give you loads of inspiration. So let's start. My first idea how to achieve and create focal point is to stamp it. What you're gonna need: ink and stamps. That's all. You could have your focal point as your titles. It could be a lovely image. Titles again, an image like this. An example for that, here is a page where you can see that my focal point here is my moth, and this is the stamp from Visible Image, actually, which I love choosing when I buy my elements, my stamps, or things that I use. I try to make sure that I will use it, that it's that it has a lot of usage, and just that it's going to be just a good buy, a good choice, and a nice big focal point. Like in this case, nice big moth, few smaller ones, some lovely embellishment, and a title. A great, great buy. That's one of the examples. Another idea for stamping. Oh, sorry, this is a page that I've done. Those are my own stamps, actually. I had them some time ago, and my focal point is stamped. This is a flower, a smaller one, a little bit of stamping here, but the main focus, where our eye is drawn, it's on my stamped element. So that's the first way to go, is stamping. And number two, how can you actually achieve? You can draw your embellishment, you can draw your image, and then fussy cut it. You can use pencils, you can use some wax pastels, you can use some markers, like here is a brush marker. You can draw it only with pencil. It's up to yourself. I'm going to show you example. This example is perfect because it's actually great when you draw and when you paint, because that's another way of doing your embellishments. You can use paints, basically. They could be just like this, watercolors. Watercolors where you use brush, and you can use some acrylic paints. You can use your finger, you can use your brush, or you can use crayons, pencils. So this actually example is for two ways. You can basically, well, here the focal point really is everywhere. It's kind of all of them are my focal point, so there's no really one thing as such, but your whole page is finished and it's pretty and it's done. And this was doodled with paints, with brushes, brush markers, and some sort of pencil. So it's a really fun way to do, and you could have that plain and have only a few circles, or whatever you decide to draw. It's up to yourself. So we have stamping, drawing, painting. Next one would be actually stickers, and I have to say this is most definitely my favorite one. And stickers, I'm talking about, let me just move that away for you so it will be just easier for us to understand everything. You can have stickers like just beautiful titles, which I totally adore, and you know me, and you know that I love that. And there are all sorts of different. You can have some booklets full of different, I'll show you here maybe, full of different stickers, and believe it or not, those are stickers. This is quite old book, so I'm not too sure if you still can buy it. But please don't look at the brand or whatever I'm showing you today. It's the ideas that I wish you to see. Even those are stickers, you know? So stickers could be great to use on your page. And my most favorite of all, for sure, are those sort of stickers. Those are 3D stickers, in this case butterflies. And I have plenty pages to show you. For example, this is a page where you have a sticker and you have your focal point as your gorgeous butterfly. And the page is done. And this one is actually stamping as well. So we have a stamping combined with sticker. And another sticker kind of thing would be washi. Those are your stickers kind of. And those are Jane Davenport, the brand new washis. Look at those. She's doing those faces element sticker washi tape. So you can actually make face and draw a little bit and use a bit of washi. Like, look at those. Awesome, awesome ideas. Let's move on. Another way for finding a focal point is to use a photograph. Just a beautiful photographs of your relatives. This is my Emily and this is my those are my parents when they were younger. And this is me. So a page made with just a photograph that I colored here, and it's just another idea for having a focal point that could be a photograph. Another one, super important, is a fussy cutting of elements from paper, basically. And look, if we just go through here, this could be your focal point, the title as it is, and it's from paper, but you can fussy cut that, no problem. Gorgeous brand new Jane Davenport papers full of focal points, or gorgeous focal points. For example, this one. You make a page, you make your own background, and you want to fussy cut that lady. Or you could, maybe that's slightly too big, but you could, for example, fussy cut maybe this lady and use for your page, or you could fussy cut this gorgeous, stunning looking girl. Or you can take an example and try to draw some sort of face for yourself. I'm sure there's plenty stamping of faces as well. So it's really up to yourself. You can also print out things from the internet, some free printables. Those are actually mine from my Etsy store, some printables of my original backgrounds, and I was using them elements to create page, and I'll show you. It is actually here. This one is the page that I used my backgrounds, and the focal point was actually different in this case, but those are also made from the just a fussy cutting, so you could really do that. And that's another example of just stamping. This one is stamping and stamping as well. Oh, important one, stickers, and this one is decoupage. Your idea is to use tissue paper. This one is made from here. So your focal point, we have like five focal points nearly here, which is absolutely perfect. You can have, if there is a weight on your page and there is some sort of composition, you could have few focal points, no problem. It's not only that it has to be one, it can be plenty, it can be no focal point and page is finished and lovely. So decoupage is another idea. Tim Holtz, for example, had those decoupage gorgeous papers, and a page with this moth. Actually, I'll show you. Let me, because I'm trying to figure out how to quickly show you the idea and also show you the finished project. And this one is the page where I have used this decoupage moth. How awesome and beautiful, and you have your focal point on the page. This video is actually on my channel. All those pages are on my channel. I would encourage you to actually go back to my older videos, because plenty of you is asking me, could you do this, could you do that, please do this. And actually the videos are there for you, and there are playlists made on my channel as well. So I try to make them into sections, which I created the playlist, and it's easier for you to actually find my videos. But there's so many videos that not all of them are fit into categories or into playlists, so it's good for you to just go back. There's 2 years of videos, so some older videos are actually outstanding, exceptional, amazing, and worth of your time to check it. So please go back to the old videos because I won't be repeating same things. Of course, I'm trying to make my content different to what was a year ago. So if you're asking me for something that is already there, you better check it beforehand. So we have those. Another one could be used is using a stencil. This is a stencil where you can either use some paint on top of that or ink or just modeling paste. So look, a stencil with a gorgeous image, and this could be easily your focal point. And lastly, it's embellishments. And this actually section is divided itself into plenty, which I'm gonna show you. We could use as our focal point a chipboard. Gorgeous chipboards. And there is so many brands out there. Have a look for yourself. This one is Skrapinias from Poland. You can easily go and shop there. You could have the Asiatic different sort of chipboard, and this gorgeous title could be your focal point. Flowers, of course, a paper or fabric flowers, those are perfect for your focal point. Metal embellishments, all sorts of metal embellishments, and another one is here like that. You could use gorgeous die-cut butterflies. I actually have them, few left in the store on my Etsy, Marry Me Small Art Etsy store, if you wish to have a look. And there is few, as I said, few left in the store, and you could purchase them from my Etsy. Another thing is like this page, which is having those gorgeous paper elements. It's like a paper die cut. Once again, those are a little sets of Amphera that I sell in my Etsy store. It's always a mix of different things. Let me show you actually what's inside this pack. And you could... There's plenty gorgeous elements, all sorts of focal points ideas actually, and smaller and bigger, all sorts of butterflies, all sorts of different elements. So those are gathered together for a beautiful set. So you can have a look in my Etsy store. Once again, I'm going to repeat myself. And this one was actually, this one was actually made from my elements from the store and the little gems. So this is my focal point, as you can easily see. What else could be as our focal point? Butterflies like that. Once again, you can find them in my Etsy store. It's up to yourself what you find. Some Amphera vintagey things, vintagey photo, and you could use all sorts of wooden elements, bigger, smaller. Of course, then the journaling and all sorts of mixed media make it heavier, they bigger, so it's different. It's up to yourself whether you want your pages to be dimensional, less or more. It's up to yourself. I will put that away and I'm going to show you my pages quickly and walk you through here. So my focal point is quite big here, and the color always kind of works together with the background and my focal point. And this one is chipboard and beautiful paper elements. This one is actually decoupage, and this one was decoupaged from a tissue paper, and the rest was coordinated, the colors were coordinated. Here we have chipboards and stenciling, but the focal point is our two stickers actually. That's how I see it. This one is, there's no focal point as such. Well, in my eyes there is no, but in a way those are kind of two focal points. But if I really think about it, I don't see it as much as focal point. This one is quite plain for me. And this one, as you can see, I'm using old bags, and it's okay to journal, do mixed media elements, do mixed media things on paper bags. There's nothing wrong with that. You make the rules, and you don't have to use journal always. Not at all. You can use paper bags, you can use packaging, you can use whatever your heart desire. And here our focal point is a fussy cutted element from paper, as far as I remember, and a little chipboard. Here again, our focal points are the words, I think, and those are stickers, once again. Oh, that's the same one, because that's from the YouTube video I've done. And this one is, again, we have gorgeous stickers as our titles and words, and just a simple sticker here of a butterfly. Butterfly is my thing. I definitely am a butterfly girl. I absolutely love, love, love butterflies. You know that. And it's very hard for me not to use butterflies. And I stopped worrying about it. I just use butterflies and that's it. This one is very textured, very much mixed media, very dimensional, very heavy and stunning in my eyes. It's one of my favorites. And here, as you can see, flowers from my Etsy store, actually. Oh, no, I'm not sure they're still there, probably not, but they are different ones in my Etsy store that you can see. And the flowers could be your focal point easily. To show you quickly a look through this book that we have done, all of those pages, you have videos on them, how to break a blank page series. So a beautiful butterfly is our focal point. Here is, we have a title, here is a stamped image as our focal point combined with those stamped circles. Here are the chipboards actually as our focal point. Here is the decoupage technique. Those are not finished, but we will finish them. This one I drawn myself, and I have used just pencils, or I don't remember. What did I use? Do you remember? But anyway, anything that draw or paint, so it's up to yourself. Those are, again, element stickers. Excuse me. My throat is funny today. This is not finished. This one is very delicate. There's no such a massive focal point. It goes actually like that. There's no such a, you know, massive focal point. It's very delicate. Page is a little title here. It's just as it is. And not always page has to have this loud focal point. I think those are not finished, but we will. Here again, those are die cuts from the magazine and stamp, gorgeous printout from internet. This one here, the whole background, the whole page is like one big focal point in my eyes. It's gorgeous. I love it, love it, love it. And those are my recent makes, I think, isn't it? Yeah, one of my recent break a blank page. And this one as well is a gorgeous, stunning fussy cutted paper. So, once again, a title, a paper embellishment, paper something. And here we have a butterfly. Here I have cut that from my actually those that I showed you, the I'll show you from those are the my own printouts. You can get them from Etsy store. I just did, they were just gorgeous, so I decided to cut from them the hearts and incorporate the background colors into them. And another butterfly again. Butterflies are everywhere as my focal point and a gorgeous background. So, you know, guys, it's like, and this actually book, there's a video on it, how I did it, if you want to see the I called it harmonica in the video, but it's actually accordion fold. I'm not a professionally I don't check things. I kind of experiment myself, and I love being wrong sometimes, and I love when you correct me. So this is accordion fold, when we can put together and bind together separate single pages. If you are curious about this video, I'm gonna give you a link at the end of this one. So we have covered my, I'll show you this one as well quickly maybe. A focal point here is a fussy cutted little girl, and the chipboards added as a addition. Here another fussy cutted elements, as you can see. And here, this is funny because there's no kind of, again, a one particular focal point. There's few of them. The composition went, as you can see, I truly love, and I think it's very much inspirational. It's strange looking, different original page, but I like it. This one have two focal points. I would say that this is nearly stronger than this one, but it is what it is. When I put things together, I kind of have to feel the weight of the page, but that's for another video. The composition thing, it's for another one. And here we have a fussy cutted beautiful element. Those are the elements I draw myself, and I fussy cutted them. So I painted those, I used watercolor. So again, guys, you can use anything you wish. Maybe I will finish one page quickly, will I? I grabbed this one. This one is vertextured. This one has some gorgeous modeling paste here. And we're gonna try and see what we can do. I'm gonna maybe use the nail colors. I didn't use them for a very long time. Those are wax pastels, very high in pigment. So I'm gonna try and see what can I do. And I'm thinking maybe to add those butterflies. So I'll grab some greens and I'm gonna just go on top of my texture with my wax pastel, and this one is very high pigmented, so I do hope that it will nicely kind of when I add water, that it will nicely just, that I will be able to color this. Yeah. It is very nice. Not the easiest way to work with. It would be probably much easier to just spray it over rather than play like this. But I figured that I just go out of my comfort zone for you, because I know that many of you have purchased this product, I'm pretty sure, and you're like, oh, but how to use it? What to do with it? No, 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 no. So that's what we will do today, I hope. You see, it's very pigmented, as you can see easily. I'm gonna grab a wipe, because I will be wiping in between, maybe. And hopefully kind of create, you know, some sort of extra element to that. Maybe, I don't know, I'm just experimenting and see. So now I'm adding more water. Not the easiest. We could actually take a watercolor here and see what can we do with that. Maybe we add some turquoise, a gorgeous teal color. It's called Mermaid. It's one of my favorite colors of those, this set. As you can see, you can combine different, what's the word, different mediums. And just because I have used the nail color pastels, it doesn't mean I cannot combine that with and continue with this some different medium. So that's what I'm gonna do. Can you, I think my throat is getting, it's not sore, but I can hear that I'm talking very strange today, like, you know, like that something is in my throat. I hope I won't be sick. Maybe I talk too much, basically. And I would not be surprised if this is the reason, actually. No. I hope to add a little more here and have a little bit of gorgeous texture scene. You see, I love working with color. This is something I adore, and I wish you to kind of as well remember that it takes time, it takes a lot of practice to understand, to be confident, but it is, you know, absolutely everything is for everyone. You can try things whenever you feel like you are ready for things, and that's it. There's no stopping. You're the only one that can stop yourself from doing things. Look already how gorgeous colors we have. It's actually the colors that I see, it's like a dragonfly, not dragonfly, the dragon, the scale of dragon. Can you see that the way as I see? Because I know that sometimes my visions are like, a what? Where do you see that? But I do see this kind of mermaidish, I don't know, something nice here. I think we have now something really nice, which I love. I'm not gonna be sick, but maybe I'm gonna lose my voice once again in my life. I can see it, sense it. And I have those, excuse me, gorgeous butterflies. Look, it's gonna be stunning. But I will add a black as well, and that's it, because I love adding black. I do have a black somewhere here. 2 seconds. Yes. If you follow, not here. If you follow me on Instagram, you did see that I am crazy about watercolors recently. I paint, there's no black here either. Oopsie. I paint like, oh, I have it here. Another Jane Davenport paints. I paint like crazy. I love, adore watercolors. I create different things like this one recently. I painted that with watercolors, and you could see that on my Instagram Facebook page. So I invite you to check my Instagram, because not everything is here on YouTube. Check the Instagram or Facebook page, Marimi Small Art, or Marta Lapkowska. You can find me on Facebook, 2 Facebook pages. And yes, that's what I created with the watercolors. And I'm in love, and I created some paintings as well of butterflies. And I have to say, I'm in total pure love with the watercolors recently, and the love is growing. I think we're making a beautiful romance together, and I'm very excited for that journey. And I didn't think I will be so mad to actually get supplies regards the watercolors, and I am. I just love it. I enjoy buying a set of new watercolors. I never understood this, because yeah, I thought that, but actually each set is different. And yeah, I love it. I'm sorry, but I do. I don't say that often, but yeah, I love watercolors, and even buying the sets. Not only the expensive ones, no. And I don't have the most expensive ones, no. I don't. I have just, you know, crafts, which are, well, Jane's are quite expensive, I have to say, but, you know, you can even get way more expensive than that, more professional for watercolor artists. I'm not watercolor artist, not even an artist, so I just have bits and pieces what I like the most, and that's what I get. So this is what we have. I'm in ecstasy love with that. Oops, I thought it's more green, but it's not. I just wanted to look. That's a mistake. That's okay. Work around it, and it's even pretty now. I just wanted a little bit of green, a little shading down, just a little, like a little, you know. No. Yeah, like a touches, so it wouldn't be that empty, and that's it. Okay. And I should dry that, and I will. This is definitely the first one. Now, this is very much, very delicate. This is very textury. So what I'm gonna do, instead of actually sticking that off from my page thing, I'm just gonna fussy cut that around and leave it not as a sticker, but as an embellishment. That makes sense? I'm just gonna keep it as the embellishment and cut around it, because I just will stick it with the 3D, the hot glue gun, because it's just too textured here, and it wouldn't hold nicely. It would lose its shape. So what's the point? As you can see, you can just change the plan, as in change even the, if this purpose was this, you can just use your way and enjoy it your way. So that's what we have at the moment. And I already totally adore this. Nice colors, isn't it? I haven't played with green for some time, I think. And this is a nice change. For a change, a nice change. Oh, guys, I love talking to you, you know. Even when I fussy cut. I never forget this amazing, funny comment. Someone said that You're the only one that while you are entertaining, while you are fussy cutting. And if that's the truth, then I'm way home. Look, I love it. Oh my god. Oh my god, I love it. Okay. So I'm gonna put it actually here. It would be so obvious here, but I'm actually gonna be not so obvious. I'm gonna put it there. But I will dry that quickly and I'll come back to you. I found a gorgeous word, and that is for you, a dedication for you guys. Friendship. Because we are friends here. I hope. I'm sure we are. So this is a little kind of sisal thing, like raffia, whatever, some sort of hay stuff, which I'm gonna put here, I hope, like this kind of, and my friendship subject somewhere. Oh, hey, why not actually be opposite to the first thought and just have it like this, or here, or here. No, I still prefer here. That's it. So what I'm gonna do is I will add some, although it's thicker, I'm gonna add some glue, hot glue, because again, it's very much, oops, it's very much here a textured page, so it wouldn't just be, because this is the packaging that we've done some time ago with the texture, and we've done some gorgeous texture. The video again on the texture, how to create texture and texture ideas, there are two videos now, is on my channel. Please get back to my older videos, have a look at the channel, because there's plenty info there, some awesome stuff. And I will add my butterfly here somewhere. Ah, no. That's what I like. I'm gonna remove that because I don't know why. it wasn't my way. And that's what we have. Our focal point, a little bit of a title, and finished piece. So guys, thank you so much for watching. I think we have it. We have that. Please let me know your ideas for a focal point. Leave me a comment below. Plenty of you is reading and you are commenting each other comments, which is fabulous because it's a great platform to do so. So please leave me a comment if you have any other fabulous ideas for focal point. I would love to hear that and read. I do read your comments. Not always reply to them, but I do read them. I pinky promise, is it? Or whatever. Pinky promise, as Emily says. And so I love to hear that, and I'm sure that all of each other would love to hear that. And most definitely, please do share that video with your friends if you enjoyed it on your social media, Twitter, Pinterest, Facebook. I would love that. Or share it from my Facebook page. If you go to Mariami's Facebook page, you can just share the link from there. If you're not too sure how to do it, you can just go on my page. And of course, guys, I should say, I hope we will meet in the cafe, a group that I created only 2.5 months ago, maybe nearly three. Was it? Well, half of December. So it's like, yeah, 2.5 months. So it's, believe or not, and it's crazy what I'm gonna say, it's 6,000 crafty friends there. Mostly beginners like you, like all of us. People who just share passion for creativity, who just create every day and enjoy it and just have power to live. And that gives them the buzz and the big happiness. So that's what's the group for, to share ideas, to show, to ask, to be for each other, with each other, support and care. And I invite you to go there, Mariami's Creative Cafe. It's the group on Facebook, it's closed group, so send a request. It takes time to be accepted. Just because we check the profiles, we want to make sure that all the nice great people are there, and we try to see that only the crafty people are invited. And yes, so we check in the profiles, and because there are so many requests, it sometimes takes a bit longer than we hope. So yes, drop us a request, we would love to have you there. All the links are below this video, so open for more description box and you will find all the links necessarily there. Yes, I'll definitely will finish at that. I enjoyed this chit chat with you today. Something different. A video, one of again most requested videos. So I hope this was helpful. If you have any ideas for more videos like that, what would you like to see? Please drop me a message, email me, say what would you like to see. Send me a message on Facebook. I would love to hear your ideas for videos. If there's something in particular you wish to see, I'm trying to catch up and make videos as you wish them for. Yes, Marta is always chatting, 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 because I don't want to say goodbye. I loved chatting to you. I hope you made a list of what I have said and you will keep that for info, for your help, for guidelines for yourself. And I hope you were creating something when I was creating, because that would be the best compliment and the best reward for me that you have done that. Create while I create, and we do it together, as in if we're in the same room. So yes, that's that's it. I will definitely chat to you very soon. So many videos planned that I only wish to have four hands, and that the day would be more than what we have, more hours in the day that we have. I need that for sure. So till the next time, guys, till the next time. Bye bye. If you hear that noise, it's Henyo. I'll try to call him. We'll see if he will respond. Henyo. Henyo. Yeah. You could hear him. Yeah. So me and Henyo. Henyo. We're saying goodbye. Have a good week. Bye. Love you loads, guys. Love you loads.